Well, I had 2 weeks vacation coming, so I thought I'd drive down to Florida, spend some time with an old friend, date a few girls, make a few parties, and just kind of live it up again. So I packed up my car, and then I called my mom in Tennessee and told her what I planned to do. She said, "Son, are you coming by?" And I said, "Mom, I'm really pushed for time, but I'll see you in a week or two." And I was driving through this little town in Georgia when I remembered, today's Mama's birthday. Well, I thought I'll just stop and wire some flowers. Shouldn't take too long, then I'll be on my way. So I walked in a flower shop, and the first thing I saw was this little boy with his eyes full of tears. I said, "What's wrong, son?" He said, "Mama loves roses, and today's her birthday, and I haven't seen her in almost a year."
Roses for Mama, today's her birthday. Roses for Mama, today's her birthday.
He said, "I live with Grandma now, but I promised Mama some roses, cause I talk to her all the time. I wanted to give her 5, cause that's how old I am. But the lady said I couldn't buy them with just a dime." Well, a little fella's story kinda touched my heart, so I told the lady to give him what he wanted and charge it to me. Then I told her I needed to wire 12 roses to my mama up in Chapel Hill, Tennessee. I looked around and the little boy was gone. But all of a sudden the door flew open and he come running back in. He said, "Mister, I forgot to thank you for the roses." He smiled, shook my hand, and ran back out again. Well, I started on out of town, and I was feeling real proud of myself for thinking of my mama and really caring. When I looked out the window and I saw that same little boy kneeling by a grave in an old cemetery. I stopped my car and walked over to where the little boy was kneeling down. And he smiled up at me and said, "This is where my mama stays. She says she sure does thank you for these pretty roses." Well, that's when I had to walk away. And I drove straight back to that flower shop and I said, "Lady, have you sent those flowers to Tennessee?" She said, "No, not yet." I said, "Well, never mind. I'll just take them back with me."